Welcome. In this series, DAX Made Easy, we're going through a plethora of DAX calculations and making them easy. Today, we're looking at AVERAGEX and AVERAGE. At the end of this video, you will have a full confidence for how to use these, when to use AVERAGEX and when not to. So let's dive into Power BI. Let's go. All right, so here we are. On the left-hand side, I'm gonna highlight my cursor here. You can see, first we're gonna talk about the high level definitions of these, and then we're gonna go into data, we're gonna build them. By the end of this, you'll get an AVERAGEX example that works really well, an idea of AVERAGE that doesn't work well, so you know how they work. It's designed to fully equip you. So let's get into it. AVERAGE, it's gonna be a simple expression. It's gonna take an average of, or the arithmetic mean, of all the numbers in a column. So it's going to require one variable. It's going to be the column you want to have the average of. If it contains empty cells, those are all ignored. And calculated values with zero are included. AVERAGEX is going to do the same sort of calculation, the average, but it's going to be evaluated over a table per row. So this function is going to ask you for what's the table name and what's the expression. We're gonna get into a great example of this pertaining to total sales with quantity and price, and we wanna get the average of that. If we use average, how it won't work at an aggregate level, and AVERAGEX, it will. So let's start by making some calculations. This file is available in the GitHub in the link in the description of this video, and we're gonna keep adding more and more DAX calculations to this, so it'll be a great source for you to disseminate how to use these things. So let's just start. We have a whole bunch of orders. The data set itself, to get an idea of what that looks like, it's a lot of orders over time. The key thing is every order line has a price and a quantity. So in this case, the price is 7, the quantity is 3, that's $21 total order. What's gonna be the average of all these orders? Well, we're gonna figure out that. So let's start by making a few calculations. Let's get into it. So new measure, and we're gonna start by creating the average of price. Average price, and this is gonna equal average, and this is, the goal of these is to show you how AVERAGEX and AVERAGE do the same thing and then how they do different things. It's designed to educate. It's not the most efficient way or best way to solve something, but it's gonna be the way to use these. You will get it. So I'm gonna do the average of price. Straightforward, let's see what that looks like. And I'm going to click it, and after every measure I create, I'm going to come up to the formatting under measure tools and set the decimals to 0. You can change that as well anytime you create a measure. So what we can see is for this order, the price was 262. Well, that averages to a price of 262 for that row. Great. And now this is saying for all of the orders under the furniture column, the average price was 350. Great, that checks out. Now the average price for all orders overall was 230. Perfect. So that works for getting that average. And now I'm gonna lay out AVERAGEX and show you how it will do the same value for this, and then we'll do something else that's different and when it's applicable. So in this case, this is when you'd want to use average. But if we make a new measure, and I'm gonna call this AVERAGEX of price, and this is going to equal AVERAGEX, and what it's gonna ask for is first the table. So I wanna do the sales table. If you're ever curious, it always shows you a little gray box. The sales table, and then the expression is just simply the column. So in this case, it's gonna be sales price. I'm gonna add this, and the goal of this again is to show you how it's the same exact value. This is no different. What this is doing, it's taking for every single row and calculating the average and adding that up and doing the same calculation. So that works exactly the same. But when we do a calculation is when it's gonna get different. So now we're gonna dive into why AVERAGEX is really needed and how to unlock that. Firstly, anytime we create measures, I always like to put them in folders. You can do that by going to the modeling view, clicking the calculations that you create, display folder. I'm gonna call this average and AVERAGEX. Cool. So now you can see they're nicely grouped in a folder, but let's start down the AVERAGEX journey. Okay, so in a previous video for some, what we did was we calculated the total sale price, which is the quantity times price. And that's going to look like this under the SUMX function, SUMX total sale. So when we do that, we can see that the total sale of this order was 2 times 262 equals 524. So the average total sale price of that order is the same thing. So I'm going to show you a calculation for how to calculate that to match and work using average, but then another way that it doesn't work. So here's the incorrect way. If we come up to make a calculation, average total sale is what I've just typed in here. And I'm going to say, take the average price and multiply it by the sum of the quantity, and I add this, you'll see it actually validates correctly with each row, saying that, okay, well, the average sale price for this was 524, but it's incorrectly calculating the aggregate. So for the category of furniture, it's not taking the averages of the average at every row level. Well, it is doing that actually, which is incorrect. It's saying, let's use these values to get the average. But what the average X function is going to do is the correct calculation at the row level. So if we add this measure, or we make a new measure, we're going to call it average X total sale. This is going to be the average of the total sale. This is going to equal average X for the sales table. We want to take the sales price times the sales quantity. And add that. And we're going to now remove or put this currency to zero just to keep it the same. So what this is now correctly doing is you can see the row is the exact same. It's taking the table and it's saying, all right, we're going to calculate the average of that order item. But now it's aggregating correctly to say, well, the average total sale price for all the orders and furniture is actually 1,820. And it is not the average that's happening when you look at just this row leveraging the quantity. So it's very important essentially to take from this that for average X, it's going to iterate over every line. So when you want to calculate something like the average of the total sale, which is the price times the quantity, then the best thing you can do and what you have to do so that aggregates correctly is to use average X. Rock and roll. So now you should get the average X and how that works. There's other videos on SUMX and things available too, so you can get into those. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the notes. I'll be happy to help you. Thanks again for watching. Take care. Bye.